Dear ESA community, this is Thomas Pesquet, Matthias Maurer. We are in Houston, just started our training, and we'd like to give you a short overview of what happened during the last 4 weeks. So what happened, Thomas?
Well, first of all, we got here, which was the hardest part. And now, I mean, just me as well as you, we're doing mostly space station training, getting ready for what's coming next year. We don't quite know yet, but there'll be flights. We'll go to space. And most of the training right now focuses on ISS systems. So for me, it's the second time that I'm going through this. For you, it's the first time. But the basis is the same. The basics are the same.
So exactly the same as for your last flight, like 4 years ago?
Now, for me this time, it's I get a lot of waivers, so I don't have to do as much as you do, which is good. But I still need to demonstrate proper knowledge and proper skills. So there's evaluations, there's masteries, as they are called here, and you need to demonstrate that you know the system. But the good thing is, you remember from the first time. I was actually surprised by how much you can remember. I thought I was going to forget everything. I forgot a lot, but not everything. So yeah, and I don't know, how is it for you? What do you think is maybe the most challenging thing in spaceflight training so far?
Well, the challenging thing is like the circumstances. I mean, with coronavirus, like training with masks, this is the only place in this entire building where we are allowed to stand without masks.
First, I probably still have the marks on my face because we're wearing masks all day long. And if you see people behind, they're wearing masks, but it's the only place and we're maintaining social distance. So we're good.
It's the outreach platform. So that is definitely a change to the training I had before. It's very compact, the training. So I have the impression it's like I get up in the morning and I'm running till the evening. And then I'm tired and I still have homework to do. A lot of the classes are remote. So that is also different from what we had in the past. Mm-hmm. But I enjoy it. And I can see that we advance forward.
Yeah.
So what do you think is like different now that we go commercial crew, we're flying US vehicles compared to the Soyuz flow?
Well, the first impact of this is actually spending much more time here in NASA. And this is maybe a good opportunity to describe just where we're standing. Building 9. This is one of the biggest buildings for space station training. It has pretty much the entire space station, but broken down into chunks. You see the modules behind us for hatch training, for emergency training. You see the different racks individually that we
cupola
take
right
apart, put back together. There's even a toilet training over there in that corner, in a dark and secret corner of that building. Robotics all the way at the back. So it's like Disneyland for spaceflight training. You could pretty much spend weeks in here without doing twice the same thing. So that's one big part. And yeah, so moving over to commercial vehicles, much less training in Russia. I've spent 76 weeks in Russia.
76?
Yeah, to be qualified on the Soyuz and on the Russian part of the space station. And this time, I think with everything that's taken into account with my experience, I'm getting to spend, I think, 3 weeks. So
3 weeks.
It's really very, very different. And on the flip side, I'm spending much more time here than I did the first time around.
Yeah. Also with the Soyuz, I mean, you were trained as a left-seater for Soyuz. How much training is that?
That's actually a lot of training because Soyuz, it's a fantastic vehicle. It's really, it's like the safest flying machine I've ever been on, and that says a lot. But it's also very, it's an old design. I mean, it's been upgraded, and now there's some better displays and some more modern interfaces. But still, it's not very automated.
Yeah.
The human element has a lot of tasks to carry out, even on a nominal flight. So you need to be really sharp. On USCV, US Crew Vehicle, SpaceX, or Boeing, obviously they date from right now. So much more automated. And then I guess you have more monitoring to do. You still need to know your system pretty hard. But for example, you don't do manual reentry in a centrifuge. That's not something you're expected to do. So I don't know. I'm happy to have done one, and to be in line to do the other one.
And the commercial crew is much shorter. It's much, much shorter for mission specialist. It's only 5, 6, 7 weeks.
5, 6, 7 weeks, which is also, I mean, it's you need to focus on what you need to know, and there's so much for the space station. It's so complicated. I mean, you know this right now because because there's this massive flow of information that you're trying to retain. And actually NASA has been good, I think, at drawing the line between, okay, this is nice to know, this you really need to know, and you have to break it down into every system. So I don't know what's your feeling on this, but I think sometimes it's frustrating because you want to know more, yeah, but you cannot retain everything. Yes, so sometimes you have to focus to what you need to know, right?
Yeah, because the information, it's like, it's a huge amount of information, and in order to absorb everything, to digest it, that's already quite challenging. And so to have already in addition information available, that is, might be a little bit too much. But yeah. Okay, for the vehicle, I have the impression on the Dragon, on the Boeing, we might be more kind of a passenger, have a not so an active role. The active role will later on be only on the station. And so yeah, that is my very first impression, but we will see once we get more insight into the commercial vehicles.
Yeah, yeah, it's a crew of four and instead of a crew of two or three on the Soyuz, so that makes a difference. Yeah. But yeah, it's going to be exciting. There was a fantastic launch. Now we need to bring those guys back.
Yeah.
And after this, then hopefully the flights are going to start. And then Europeans are going to get their seats on their vehicles. So it's going to be exciting.